What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today, I'm just going to give you kind of a brief update on what's going on with the C5. I've just been doing a little bit of tinkering on it. There was just a few odds and ends that were wrong with the car. So hopefully we're getting everything straightened out, so it's going to be good to go here pretty soon. So let's take a look. So I did mention a while ago that my mirror somehow broke, but I did end up fixing it. I didn't do a video on this though because I was kind of in a hurry to get it fixed, but I am going to do the other side when I get a little bit more time. But just a brief rundown, I'll show you guys. I've took some pictures along the way. I'll show you guys what I did. So inside this part of the mirror, there's a post that sticks up into this part of the mirror, and there's a little groove around that, and then this clip is what holds that into place. There's actually a spring that this holds into place, so that spring is under tension, so that's what gives this thing that kind of click into place. That spring is holding tension of this part down onto this part, so when this part came off, the spring release tension, and the mirror was just flopping around. So there's a couple of things that are odd about that, and one of them is the wire that controls the mirror goes straight through the middle of the spring, so that poses an issue, and also that spring is super strong, and there's no way to compress that spring while it's inside the mirror. So basically what I did is, to start off, I had to take the door panel of the driver's side off to get access in there. I have to undo the wiring harness, and then there's two plugs on the end of the harness that go to the mirror. So in order to get the wire out of the mirror, you actually have to cut off cut the wire somewhere in the middle. I opted to cut the wires closer to the plug-in side rather than on the mirror motor side. So, and then later on, when I got it all back together, I actually soldered the wires back together, put heat shrink on them, and they're good as new. But in order to pull the wire through that post, you have to get those two ends off. Otherwise, those ends are fatter than the hole inside the post, and you can't get the wire through. So that was one little issue that we had to go through. So now I'm going to show you some of the pictures that I took along the way. So in this photo, you can see I'm actually cutting off the tip of that post that goes through the bottom side of the mirror. So I'm actually right where the saw blade is where that groove that goes around and where that clip goes into place. So I'm going to cut off the tip of this post right here, and then later on you're going to see what I'm going to do here. So now I'm taking a piece of, I believe it's 1/4 inch threaded rod. This can be found in the lighting department of pretty much any hardware store. So it's hollow down the middle, so that's where our wires are going to go through. So this threaded rod is going to go inside that post that you just saw me cut the tip off. So here you can see I've put the threaded rod through that post, and then I've put a nut on the bottom side and I put Loctite on there, so there's no way that that is going to back itself off. So that's the bottom side of the mirror. So now let's go ahead and take a look at the top side. So here's the top end of that post. You can see the threads poking through there a little bit. So now we need to stick this thing through the inside of the mirror, get that spring back on there, and then we're going to put a nut on the top side with a washer under it so we can use that to compress that spring inside the mirror. So here's a photo of the top side. This is inside the main part of the mirror. You can see the nut on the top side of the spring, and then you got the fender washer and then the nut on top. I put Loctite on that as well, so there's no way that that thing is going to back itself off. So now we've got a solid, I mean, this is way solid, way better than what the factory had. And then here's the final photo with the wires shown going through the middle of that threaded rod, all put back together and good to go. So, like I said, that's just kind of the short and sweet version of that. I am going to do a full video tutorial on how to do that. This is a very common issue on C5 Corvettes. I'm sure the C6 is probably going to have the same issue as well if it hasn't already. But currently my passenger side mirror is working just fine, but inevitably it's going to happen to that side as well. So I may as well get that done now, whenever I get some free time, and go ahead and do that side as well, because that mirror is never going to have that issue ever again. That thing is solid as a rock. Next on the list is that squeaking pulley issue that I've been just pulling my hair out about for probably the past 3 or 4 months or so. So you guys have seen, I have replaced the belt tensioner multiple times. That wasn't the issue, apparently, or at least it didn't solve the issue. Maybe the tensioner was going bad initially, and maybe another pulley had an issue. I really don't know, but we've kind of ruled that out. We've got a brand new tensioner on there. I actually went ahead and took the AC belt off the car entirely to rule out the AC compressor, the AC belt tensioner, and the AC idler pulley. So those three pulleys are kind of out of the equation now. So now the only other things that could be in question are the main engine idler pulley, the alternator, the power steering pump pulley, or the harmonic balancer. So I went ahead and put a new idler pulley on the car the other day. I got a couple of clips here. All right, so here's the old idler pulley. Take a listen. Now, here is the new idler pulley. So, if that pulley isn't the one that was causing the squeaking, it was definitely going bad anyways. You could definitely hear those bearings were not in the best shape. So we got a brand new idler pulley on the car. I also got a new belt. Everyone on the forums says to use the Continental Elite belts. They used to be called Goodyear Gatorbacks, but then Goodyear, I guess, bought Continental and they did some brand changing there. But Continental Elite belts sold at AutoZone apparently don't squeak, unlike some other belts that do fit the car. But I guess that's the one to get, so that's the one that I got. And then I also discovered a little bit of a squeaking noise coming from the alternator. Check this out. I think I may have just discovered something. So here's the alternator. Take a listen to this. So I just sent my alternator out to get rebuilt. That should be back tomorrow, actually. So unfortunately, we're not going to be able to find out in this video if any of those things solved my issue. But if none of those things solve the issue, the only thing left is the harmonic balancer. And I've been seeing all of your guys' comments. I know a lot of you have been asking me if it's the harmonic balancer. I don't know, but I'm hoping not, because that is a really terrible project. So if it does happen to be the harmonic balancer, I would definitely switch it out to an ATI harmonic balancer, which will run me around $450, and then labor for somebody else to install it would be around $600. So close to $1,000 all around. So hopefully it doesn't come to that quite yet. My harmonic balancer is not wobbling at the moment, so Hopefully that is not the issue, and hopefully one of the other two things that I just changed out, or three, I guess, if you count the belt, hopefully one of those solves my problem. So next thing on the list for the C5 is actually a couple of things, but they're going to be done by the same person. And that is, I need to redo the clear bra on the front of the car because it's got some damage here on the front. This happened a while ago. So I got this installed about almost 3 years ago. The product is called SunTech. And it was definitely a cheaper product. I really wish I would have went with Expel, because if something like that happens to Expel, it has a lifetime warranty and they will replace it for free 100%. So kind of lesson learned on my part. So I'm going to have a dynamic tint. You guys have seen them do the tint on my truck. They're going to install the Expel front bumper clear bra, and I'm going to have them do the ceramic tint as well. I've been needing tint on this car for years, just been kind of putting that off, but since they're already doing this, I may as well have them do that as well at the same time. And then, after I get the clear bra and the tint done, something that I have been putting off for way too long, I'm going to finally get the C5 paint corrected and ceramic coated. I don't know why I've put this off for so long. I literally have almost like every other vehicle that I own apart from the Corvettes are ceramic coated. I've partially been putting it off because they stay in the garage. The cars that sit outside, they take a little bit more of a beating. So having that ceramic coated is a good thing, but the Corvettes, they need a little bit of love, so I'm going to finally get that done, and really looking forward to that. And then, hopefully, as long as that pulley chirping sound is gone, I want to do one more day trip in the C5 this year before it gets really hot here in Arizona. Probably going to do the same trip that I recently did in the C4. That is a great drive. You guys seem to enjoy that as well. So it'll be interesting to see back to back that same trip in two different cars. So something to look forward to. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it wasn't as thorough as some of my other videos, but just a little update on what's going on here at the My Corvette Life Garage. Once I get the C5 kind of settled back down and it doesn't have any issues going on, we'll get back to some of the C4 action. I still have a few other things to install on the car, such as I finally got those shocks that were on back order for so long. Those are ready to put on the car. I got the fuel filter to do. I also need to go get a quote for some paint work done on the car. So that is coming up in a video here pretty soon. So stay tuned for that. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. Until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.